Good afternoon. Lisa here with New Start University, and I want to talk to you and hopefully challenge you about the labels that you choose to own. And I don't mean the labels that are assigned to you, but the ones that you choose to embrace. You see, my 8-year-old is not here right now, but I am pretty sure that if I asked him who he was, that he would tell you that his name is Tyler Salee. I recently asked my 18-year-old and his girlfriend both who they were, and they both had a few more labels that they had already identified with, and they gave me their name. Then they told me that they were the son and daughter of their parents' names. They went on to tell me that they were seniors in high school, and they went on to tell me about their interests. The list went on and on. You see, as you live, you have different life experiences, and there's different labels that you choose that you're going to own or not. Some of them are really good labels. Like the first time I found out I was going to be a mom, I can't even tell you how excited I was. That was a label that I just wanted to shout out to the world and tell everybody that I'm going to be a mom. And just last night, I found out that I'm going to be a mother-in-law. And that's really exciting. You know why? Because that means that I raised a son that was lovable and honorable because he talked to her parents first. But in all seriousness, you know, there's labels that we absolutely love, like I love being my husband's wife. You know, there's labels that we're proud of that are because of our accomplishments. Like when I was a bank manager, I was very proud of, you know, the hard work it took to get there. You know, if you're a stay-at-home mom, you can be very proud of that label because that means that you're working really, really hard to keep your house in order and get your kids everywhere they need to be. There's so many different labels that we can be proud of. But then, unfortunately, there's those labels that kind of get assigned to us that we're not so proud of and we're not sure what to do with, and so we just decide to wear them and own them. For example, I remember vividly being in high school in my forensics class, and there was a boy in there that was kind of poking fun of me one day and told me that I was short and stumpy. Now, I am short, and I wish he didn't have to throw the stumpy part in there, but he did. And I'm telling you, I'm 43 years old now, so you do the math and see how long it's been since I've been in school. Every day when I look in the mirror, that's the first thought that I used to see. I used to think, well, there's Lisa. She's short and stumpy. Once I really started diving into God's Word and realizing that, no, I'm so much more than that, that I'm a daughter of the King, the same person that made the sun and the stars and the moons and the galaxy, he looked around and thought, you know what? The world needs one of Lisa also, and he created me. Once I was able to let go of that and just be sure of who I was able to shed some of those labels. And I'll be honest, it's taken me a very long time. It's taken me a lot of soul searching. I have taught the same lessons to high school girls in church over and over and over again, telling them how they should be proud of who they were and how they shouldn't let the world assign labels on them. Yet I never internalized that. I never took my own advice. I didn't heed what I was telling them until recently. And I have to tell you, the last year of really just focusing on me and being a little bit selfish in that and trying to figure out who I am and what I like, it has been so freeing. And that's only because, honestly, in my opinion, because I have sought out what God's Word says about me. And I know that I don't need to be insecure. And for the first time in my life, I can honestly tell you that I know who I am. I'm proud of who I am. And I can walk into any room and just hold my head high and know who I am and that I have every right to be there just like anyone else. And when I was trying to decide what I was going to be talking about today, I just love how God speaks to me. Because when I walked into work, there was this coffee. Can you see that? There was a coffee sleeve sitting on my desk. And it says, "Be you on purpose." And I think that is absolutely amazing advice. Instead of worrying about being somebody else and worrying about all these other labels that people throw on you, be you on purpose. I'm going to be blogging about this later this afternoon, so watch for the link on my Facebook page to read a little bit more about how you can be you on purpose. Have a great day.